your friends in complete disbelief. What is happening to the world? It feels like we're living in an upside down Alice in Wonderland time, when right is wrong and wrong is right. We have given the world so much proof as to what's going on to the hostages. We have had women speak out about acts of cruelty that I cannot even say out loud. And yet, what do we see? What do they hear? Blah, blah, blah. There you go. Why? Why? So, okay, I want us to know the why. Because without the why, we cannot bring them home. Without the why, we cannot end this war. So I want to understand the why. And here we go. In the 1920s in this country, Henry Ford bought a newspaper, called it the Dearborn Independent, and published the Protocols of the Elders of Zion. By the way, in 2002, these books, which basically state that Jews control the world, you know what? It is the dumbest thing ever. There's only 16 million of us. Everybody attacks us, and we're the ones who are supposed to control that. It's ludicrous. He went and said that the biggest issue in America is the Jewish problem. Columbia University, every major university in this country, in 1933, started sending students to Nazi Germany. College administrators got on boats with Nazi flags and went to Germany. As late as the last minute before the war, there was a student exchange program between Nazis and Jews. Think about that. I mean, excuse me, between Nazis and universities. Think about that. We read about Qatar. We read about all these people funding the university. It's much deeper than that. It goes much, much deeper. Hatred of Jews has been around since time immemorial. And this country has a history of destroying the Jewish people. This country has a history of turning away Jews who came on a boat escaping Nazi Germany, knowing they were sending them back into death. I want to read to you something that happened in 2002, not in 1912, not in 1855. In the University of Manchester's student union declared that anti-Zionism isn't anti-Semitism. A leaflet from the General Union of Palestinian Students, quoting a neo-Nazi forgery entitled The Prophecy of Ben Franklin in Regard to the Jewish Race, described Jews as vampires, and said that if Jews were not expelled from the USA, they would enslave the country and destroy its economy. When they failed to pass their motion to absolutely boycott all Israeli products, what did they do? They put posters all over the university saying, slaughter the Jews. In 2006, a parliamentary inquiry into anti-Semitism reported, when left-wing or pro-Palestinian discourse is manipulated and used as a vehicle for anti-Jewish language and themes. In 2003, you have Patrick Klugman, a French student who said that the climate has been so difficult and that in the name of the Palestinian cause, they are castigated as if they were Israeli soldiers. We hear death to the Jews during demonstrations that are supposed to be pro-Palestinian. The why is that we have been complacent. The why is that this has been going on for tens and tens of years. They have been planning this day for the last 100 years. They have been sowing the seeds of hatred, of anti-Semitism, calling Jews vampires in 2002. This, we had all the warnings. And when I say we, I mean me. My son went to Columbia University. Every day he would come home and tell me, Ima, This happened to me that was anti-Semitic. A teacher humiliated a Jewish student. A teacher called Israel an apartheid state. And you know what I said? All right, there's always gonna be people who hate Jews. I was complacent. We were complacent. And there is only one way to bring the hostages home. And that is every Jewish person, every ally of the Jewish people, every Iranian woman who knows what it's like to live under Hamas and Hezbollah.
Yes.
When the Iranian women marched, I spoke and led the march in Washington, D.C. in their support. Do you know what they marched against? They marched against the same laws that Hamas imposes, against the fact that they cannot travel, marry, have a profession without a man's permission. This is what university students are calling freedom? This is what university students want?
Shame!
I want us to think about World War II in a different way. When did the war end? When did Germany surrender? When it couldn't protect its citizens anymore. When their army couldn't fight. Wow. Who was supposed to surrender now? How do you stop the innocent slaughter of Muslims, of Palestinians, of Jews? It's simple. Surrender Hamas, bring home every fucking single hostage. That's how you end the war.
I want
to leave one message to all those students, marching in what is now clear and obvious is not pro-Palestinian. It's just fucking anti-Jewish. But I want them to think about one thing. The freedom that they're quote unquote fighting for is Sharia law. The girls in those colleges who are sitting there in their tank tops and their shorts would be fucking arrested in Hamas rule. The students, do you know that under Sharia law, a man can marry off his 13-year-old without her permission? Do you know that in Sharia law, if a woman refuses her husband sex, he has no legitimacy to take care of him? This is what they're fighting for. The only way to stop this is to scream in every corner, not to be afraid. I ask the people who are not here, I ask the people who have kept silent, I ask every person to bring them home!
Bring them home! Bring